Hi, welcome to another program. Today we want to, as you see, I am now in a hotel room. I'm actually in Madrid, and I am just here for a personal business. And tonight I am coming back, so hopefully from the next week's program, I will be at home doing my videos now. And we want to talk about the farm or the agriculture problems in Turkey, because the farmers are uprised. And the unrest is now getting widespread in not only the Dardanelles region, but also the other regions in Turkey, which is not a good sign, because they are the source of the votes for AKP, which is going to affect the future, or which has already affected some on the future elections. So without further ado, let's start what's going on in Turkey. The agriculture industry is in a big problem. Not only agriculture, but all the industries are in a big problem. Because in Turkey, I do not believe that we have poverty. I do not believe that we have a problem of economy. I think we have a moral problems. We have a problems of stealing. We have a problems of moral acts, characters, honesty. This is the Turkey's problems, not the poverty. Poverty is only the result of these kind of things. I am in Madrid, I am living in Vienna, and the prices are much more cheaper than in Turkey, despite the fact that Turkey should have produced these, at least the farm or the agriculture products cheaper than Europe. Since it is the case, it becomes a problem. Why? I mean, believe me, I am a farmer too. In Turkey, I have a small farm. I just restructure it, and I will wait for another like maybe 7-8 years more to get my first product. It's orange, if you must know. So it's now, the trees are 2 years old almost, and I need to wait 7-8 more years so that I can start the products. But anyway, it's not a problem. Once you produce, let's say, a product in Turkey, and the farms are selling to the other intermediate points before it comes to the plate of the, let's say, the consumers, they sell it like let's say 1 euro, for you to understand. But when it comes to the consumer's plate, it's around 4 to 5 euro, and that's the goddamn problem in Turkey. The intermediate points are getting all these monies. So is it about the laws? Of course not. It's about the other things? Of course not. It's about the moral things. It's about the characters. It's about the decency. It's about being a liar or being a thief about this. It's nothing about any other things. For also farmers, it is the same problem. Yes, they have been voting for Erdogan and his party mostly, I have to admit. And despite the fact that it has been told to them that it's nothing about the nationalism or other things and national security and other things, they have neglected listening. But now it comes to their pain, or basically now they start also suffering greatly, which they cannot resist anymore. Now they start saying, you know, I'm not going to vote for you, I'm a price, and you should go leave the government, so on and so forth. So yeah, everybody is wrong about almost everything else in Turkey. But as I said, the poverty is not the problem. Economy is really not the problem. The real problem is decency, honesty, stealing, and character. We have to admit that the Turks, maybe 200 or 300 years ago, they were more decent than today, now become very much corrupted people. And this has to change by applying really strict rules and laws. And unless it is, not a government like AKP or Erdogan can stand, but any government cannot stand a long time. So that's the real problem in Turkey. So what is now going to happen, that of course it might widespread, and we can see a lot of farmers burning their products and so on and so forth. But the real, I believe, stress will be on industrial, and we will feel it more and more during the winter time, when they are supposed to be making and generating and developing all these things. And they will start that unemployment rate is increasing, and they don't have many much, let's say, orders. Capacities are, very, very low, and they will also start stressing or pressuring on the government for an early election. Now, if early election will take place, it's another story, then definitely AKP is going to lose, or a snapshot elections. But Özgür Özel will likely to win mostly, for sure, or İmamoğlu, whoever will be. Let's see. Is it going to happen? That's a very big question, to be honest. I do not believe that Erdogan will likely to happen it, and he will try to do everything to avoid such a snapshot, because he knows that he will not be elected again. For sure, he will not be elected. It is unlikely that there will be an uprising, I will say protests against him. It will be even increasing. So this is now the question, how much he can stand in futures to such protests. That's the big question, and he has still capacity. He can play with it. He can print money, and the inflations will rise. He will do everything as he can, try to extend this period so that he surprisingly expect that the economy will recover. Unfortunately, economy will not recover because, as I said, the real problem in Turkey is people, the thieves, and dishonesty, morality. If you bring 1 euro as a 5 euro or 6 euro in front of myself as a plate, there is no moral about this. There is nothing about that. I'm sorry. So the real problem is this. So let's see. So if you like these contents and you would like to follow it more, please subscribe to my channel. Have a nice day. Bye.